My name is Esther and you're welcome to your home of Pieros of Entertainment, reality TV show reviews and what have you. Please do wait to subscribe and welcome to the family once again. By the way, still praying for South Africa. This too shall surely pass. So my people, I bring to you interesting gist straight from the oven. Don't worry, this one is going to quench everything. I know you missed me. Don't worry. So juicy from the bilingi of the video to the end, garnished with some weekend goodness. Yeah. So by the way, hope you had a stress-free week, especially my negotiations. The flood was massive. I trust you did. Yeah, I trust you did. All right, so let's start already. First on the list, the boss lady herself, Katrina, counts her blessings as she celebrates her 27th birthday. She said, "Counting my blessings at 27, famous, checked. Husband who is a crown over my head, checked. My adorable daughter who makes me feel I have everything good in life. 3 houses in Nigeria, the latest one in Spain, and many actors. No doubt I'm aging gracefully. HBD. Indeed. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Great. Nothing like being alive to see another year." And people, I am really grateful on her behalf. She also has been receiving gifts left, right, center. She got a special message and a new house from my husband. Oh, is he his husband? Wait, this divorce was separated. Anyway, it's beautiful to see. Happy birthday, dear Katrina, boss lady herself. Live on, shine on. Cheers to more greatness ahead, dear. On to the next one, Tacha on the global level. Hey, this one is big. So MTV officially announced the cast for the 37th season of the challenge Spies, Lies and Allies, and yours truly, Tacha and Esther from Big Brother Niger season 4 are among the cast, alongside 32 others from different countries. So they released trailers, they released their casting pictures, and just in case you're wondering what it is all about, yeah, it is. Let me help you out. You guys trust me now, so let's help you out with information and everything you need to know. Expanding every year, MTV Base just reviewed the cast of the challenge Spies, Lies and Allies, and a first look at the 37th of the reality competition series. We feature 17 international players and we roll out globally in over 190 countries. The 19th episode includes a cast of 34 members who form on the coast of Croatia elite USA agents join forces with an assortment of international operatives, all armed with killer competitive instinct. Hey, Oshie. The press release review with the assignment constantly evolving. These agents will be tested both mentally and physically to win their share of $1 million in this epic new chapter of the challenge spy games. Can you imagine, guys? What a whooping sum of $1 million. This one is big. So you can see that it's not a small something, guys. So Esther and Tacha are our very own, based on the BB Niger and all of that. So who are you supporting and why? For now, Tacha is already appearing on Trend Table in America, for that matter, ahead of this. In fact, she got massively praised on US Weekly podcast, saying that she stood out and is up to be a fan favorite. Like, people are really going to love her when the show starts. Okay, let me play so you can hear what they said about Tacha.
And I sense a lot of early support for Tacha here. Really? Yeah, I do. I think she's going to be a favorite. I think people are going to root for her. This is a name, when I look at these names, a list of names, the one that stood out to me was hers. So that tells me that people have been talking about her. And I think, you know, she's somebody who I think, other than the Survivor cast members that people have seen, I think she's someone that could become a fan favorite on this season.
Yeah, excited. Anyone who can ruffle feathers but also can last that long on a show like Big Brother has some sort of great social game.
So you can see, though it's a recorded show, but I won't give you guys a spoiler because I've heard like how far they went and all of that. So I won't give you guys a spoiler at all. So just watch out for the show itself. So it's going to start August 11th. The truth still remains that when the show is finally being aired globally, the girls, I mean Esther and Tacha, we also get a global recognitions and fans support all over the world, like Niger to the world. But man, the girls tried, because after watching all of this jumping into the water, mountain flying like a monkey and snakes everywhere, nah, I promise you I won't last in 4 hours. So no matter how much they lasted, or they went in the game, just give it to them, guys. Like, man, I can't come and die, kill myself. Mban, lie, I can't kill myself. And another funny thing is the way they use what happened to Tatcha during the show. I mean, the fight. They use that same fight to decide her success and how far she might go in the game. For me, it's so amazing. Like, life is so funny, Sha. Very, very funny. So share your thought with me at the comment session. Moving on to some more beautiful stories. Ozo's sister Fresh Int on Ozo and Nengi's relationship status. So one of Ozo's sisters by the name Zinichiku, oh yes, is his cousin, but then we can still call her his sister, of course. And recently Ozo still celebrated her, so she must be very, very close to them. So she boldly revealed that she's a proud Ozone shipper. They are asking, Esther, what do you mean? Okay, calm down. So one of the VVIP acts via posts on Twitter, she was like, mention your top five favorite Ozo moments. Let's go. Like, she was asking them to mention their top five favorite Ozo moments. Only for Zinichiku to reply with, when the show was over. Wow. Meaning after the BB Niger activities, after all the old drama and beautiful scenes we saw in the house, both of them following each other, eating together and all of that, she has seen, of course, she has definitely seen more and even way better of the two of them together. Or what do you think, beyond what we saw in the house? Or guys, or what do you think she meant by what she wrote? So that was October last year. A few hours ago, my people, this same post was quoted. A reply was quoted, just like the way you're seeing it on the screen now. Then she replied again with, still my favorite moment. Yeah, she's his cousin and all of that, but truth still remains that she's more closer, like she's closer to them, knows what is going on between those two, Yellow Purpose to an extent, seeing how their friendship has grown beyond the camera, and can only keep it a secret till the parties involved decide to spill themselves. I mean, for her to say it publicly now, guys, what do you think? For her to say this publicly, what do you think? And like Abigail usually say at the comment section, she will say nobody really knows what is going on between Ozo and Nengi except Ozo and Nengi themselves and their close relatives. So should we not agree that the Int Zini is giving us is reliable? I mean, she's actively participating in Ozo matter, replying on Ozone's posts on Twitter without even being forced. Not like she was forced. To the extent that this recent one, even the person who made the post was surprised of how she's involved and wanted her to spill more. People were like, ah, please spill more now. You know how Ozone shippers can be. Spill more now. She even wanted to go ask her in her DM to spill more and tell her more about everything happening between them outside the house. But then the person was like, ah, she's kind of scared of this particular Chiku. Imagine me DMing her about a ship. Guys, you wouldn't believe what Zini's reply was again. What you are seeing on the screen right now. And she was not even angry or anything. Means it's all love here. No worries. Amazing stuff. Well, as far as most people are concerned, she's an insider. And truth is, if the friendship was a bad one, Ozo and Nengi's friendship was a bad one, everybody in the family were not in support, or both Nengi and Ozo are not together or as close as they used to be in the house again, I'm so sure she won't even put her mouth. Not to talk of saying that her favorite moment of Ozone was after the house. So guys, as you remember the last thing we heard of Ozo and Nengi, maybe it might just be true at the end of the day. Well, time we tell. To the next stories, I've not also had the chance to talk about this one. I won't forgive myself if I don't talk about it. Nengi is not stepping down anytime soon, or backs another role in the new movie. So according to reports, guys, and now this is what I want to say, that is why I have to talk about it. So according to reports, Yomi Black was so impressed by Nengi I'm seeing in Nkoyo and decided to cast her in his new movie. You all remember that same guy that was saying a star is born when they were on the set of Nkoyo? Yes, it's that same one featuring her in his new movie. He actually meant it when he said a star is born there. So he went as far as making sure that no, she must work in my new movie. They are presently on the movie set cooking the delicious meal for everyone, different locations, pampering them. The movie, you go get taste, die. Mad delicious classy taste. With all this pampering, you guys get. The movie is also starring Elizona, Jimmy, Ozo's King Boys co-host, the ICN, and I also found out that it will be released by October this year. So like Yomi Black said, fasten your seatbelt for this blockbuster. Yeah. Also this one, I must talk about it too. Watoni has been making me so proud lately. like really, really proud. Like, she has not also come here to play. So after a successful hosting gig alongside Ike of Ultimate Love, she's also on a movie set. So movie title not reviewed yet, but it's looking interesting. I mean, the likes of Nosodio B, Nuella, and the likes, it's gas be big. So I cannot wait to see what it's also cooking. Though some people are saying, must everybody be an actress, can she even act? Well, me, there's nothing bad in trying your hands on new things, and if she can, why not? My take, oh, well done Wathoni. Kid Wire, oh, hey, can they leave my boy alone? Can they leave Kid Wire alone? So someone said, asked him and said, please stop, this community boy lifestyle is destroying your name. Why do people leave this guy alone? But trust Kid Wire now, you know they carry last. He said, my name matters where it's important, not amongst the local community gossipers. Yeesh, this one enter. That's the difference between me and them. Wow. Please stop calling Kid Wire community boy. You guys should leave this guy alone. And he's not troublesome. Always minding his business. You guys should leave him alone. Which one is community? It's just the way he is. Friendly, cruise master. I don't think it's like that. You guys should just leave him alone, please, I beg. And I love the reply he gave, Sha. Kid Wire always repping. Well, last on today's video, guys, some weekend vibes for you, okay? So Lekan pays back. What do I mean? Over the week, Lekan paid Mama Tega a courtesy visit at a store in Yaba. You remember that woman Lekan mentioned during the show? I mean, when we were still in the house and how. Just by mentioning her alone, people started buying stuff from that woman. That even the woman had to organize voting center in front of a big store for Lekan when he was staying in the house. So Lekan paid her a visit, and my people, the massive crowd that came out in just short notice is something else. Man, Lekan is bled no cap. Last, social media no be real life. Nah, confirm. Shine out, dear Lekan. Lastly, we should all learn to always appreciate people, no matter how small. Why we still can, why all of us are still alive. Why not spread love, show love, just because. So guys, that's all I have for you, just for you to step down this beautiful Sunday.